Welcome to Upgrade. I'm your host, Frank the Tank. And today, I'm going to bring in the Legion 5. We're going to take a look at it and see what you get when you purchase one like this. And we're going to take a look under the hood, too. So let's stick around. All right, let's take a look at the beast itself. First of all, here, the actual keyboard itself. The box is pretty heavy. I mean, it's like more than a pound heavy. And we're talking about it's a 300 watts power surge, all right? So power protector. And of course, you know, Lenovo always has a yellow tip. It's very unique for their style of setting up these systems, of course. So I'm gonna go ahead and open it up. First time opening it up, nice little system in here. And let's take a look at the actual back end of it first of all. All right, if you guys can see the back, we're gonna start here with the power, one USB, HDMI, USB, and USB, and Type-C USB. And then you have your NIC input, your NIC card, that actually you connect your RJ45 here. And then you got these heat dispensers in here. So we're gonna take a look at it. And in the bottom, you got another area where it sucks all the air in, pretty much air flows in here. Let's take a look at the side. On the side, it's very simple. You got one input for a USB, and then you have a SD card reader in here, right? That's pretty much what it is. Let's flip it around the other side. On the other side, you got your audio connection, your 3.5 audio connection, and then you have another Type-C connection. So this is perfect if you're gonna do VR with glasses, because a lot of the VRs are coming out with the Type-C connection. This is perfect, and you require two. This is good for you. So let's go ahead and take a look at the inside. All right, taking a look at the inside is very simple. You get a full keyboard, a 10 key keyboard inside. It's all compact in there. They pretty much wasted a lot of the space in here and pretty much concentrate everything on the keyboard itself. It's actually giving you some instructions how to control the RGB lighting that's going to go on here. It has a Ryzen 7 500 series, a 5000 series CPU in here. Of course, it comes with the RTX 3070. I know I reviewed a 3080 Alienware, but this is a lot better machine. We're gonna talk a little bit why it's a little bit better, and it can handle pretty much a lot of the games that are out there, or the upcoming games that are gonna be out there. We're gonna talk a little bit more about that too. So let's go ahead and take a look, and then we're gonna open the back and see what's on the hood too. All right, we're gonna do a test. And if you can see, I have one light here and I'm gonna turn it off right now. Maybe it'll be better. And if you can see, I don't have no lights, but one light in the top. So it pretty much helped out a little bit, of course, but the audio and everything's coming out of the actual camera. And this is nobody builds a really good camera these days on the laptops no more. They don't spend too much because they need extra space, and they want to make sure you get a thin monitor instead of a thicker one. So that's why you get the cheap 720 video camera that you have right now, and that has a little shutter that you can close. You can close and you can open. That's pretty much close and open. So it's not bad. Audio-wise, let me know what you think. I'm going to hear it later on and see. I'll come back with my review and see what you think about it. So let's take a look. All right, let's take a look at the machine itself, all right? So there's a couple of things that you have to know about before you're going to purchase something like this. And first of all, we're going to take a look and see what you can upgrade, all right? On this particular machine, you can upgrade the battery itself, and then you have the M.2. It's hidden in here. You're not gonna find it unless you remove the screws. And there's another slot for an M.2 NVMe that you can install in here. So I did remove the actual screws because I need to fix this little bend thing. It was a little bend, the aluminum. As you see it, I'm trying to fix it as much as I can, but it does hide another slot right here where we have, and they give you one. And this is probably it's the longest one that you can find right now. And pretty much they don't give you a secondary slot in here that you could add to it if you got the shorter versions of it, of the NVMe, or the long version of the NVMe. So there's up to 80 millimeters. So just remember which one are you gonna purchase and which one you're gonna have installed in here. So we have a second slot for this. You could replace the battery, you could upgrade the NVMe, the first one that you have in here, and add a secondary, or maybe add a 2 terabyte instead of 1 terabyte. Or now that you're gonna get Windows 11, you wanna make sure you wanna start a fresh start. You can do that by buying another NVMe and starting in here. And we're gonna open it up so you guys can see it. what I'm talking about, and it's not that hard, but they make it, you gotta make sure you got the right tools to open these up, right? Recommendation is, you're gonna void your warranty if you crack anything in there, so be careful how you open it. I did have a little problems opening it, and I'm gonna show you guys what I did for reference. I actually went to YouTube and found another video that had a reference how to open it. It was an older video, but it's irrelevant to the same system. It's pretty much, they haven't changed their systems, the way they built them, the actual case. So we're gonna take a look at that too. All right, we're gonna remove the case. We remove the screws, of course, and just be careful when you remove it because it does have a thermal paste. If you guys can see on the top, thermal paste. Now here, you're gonna find your wireless card adapter here, this input for the WAM card adapter. The wireless card goes in here, and then they give you a 1 terabyte, all right, of NVMe. Of course, you could upgrade this one. It's not the greatest, all right, but we are also gonna upgrade this system too at the same time. So we're gonna take a look at that. How do you do that too? They give you the GPUs on this side and the CPUs, of course, always on the right. It's right here. It has a good way of protecting the system, keeping everything out of the actual touching. If you guys can see, there's no motherboard in here that you have to worry about. So airflow is gonna be pretty good on it. The motherboard actually starts from here and here, but there's a big gap that goes all around so you can see the airflow, how it floats through one direction. So battery, you can replace the battery. It's not that hard. There's a couple of screws you gotta remove. Here, here, and here, and here. And just pretty much follow the instructions. You do have to disconnect it prior to actually doing any kind of modifications. If you're gonna put thermal paste on any of these systems, you can replace the thermal paste too, but you gotta make sure you unplug it too. Not that much you can do other than upgrading the actual NVMe's to adding a secondary, and that's all you can do. So we're gonna take a look at it and come back and see how it could handle some of the games. On this machine, particular machine, not that much heat is it's coming out of it. It's actually pretty good. If you guys can see it, it's holding, retaining very good. It's not that hot as it is. You can see a little burning spot right here, but overall it's holding itself. And I'm looking at the XPS 13 is really simple. I'm gonna turn it around so you guys can see a little bit in back of it where the heat's coming from. It's actually not even exhausting from the back that much. It's all coming up from the front. And the vents, if you guys can see, there is no vents that much in here. It does get a little hot right here. It's a little warm, but the vents are actually in between the monitor itself. So that's not bad. I like it that it's running really simple, really quiet. I can't even hear the machine itself. The vents on the side, let me turn it so you guys can see the bottom of it. This is where all the heat evaporates from, right there in the back. That's the hottest spot that you have, but overall it's maintaining itself really quiet, really it's retaining the heat really well. It's spreading it around. It doesn't get hot. It looks like it's hot, but that's an internal stuff. It's not even hot at all. So all right, so first of all, maximum resolution 1920 by 1080. This is pretty much what we get on the system. We're buffering, we're pretty much high-end. We're gonna put as much as we can in here. Let's see if we can play this game and how well it looks in here. So let's go ahead and start. So we're gonna ready up. It's really quiet mode, so I'm louder than the freaking computer, and it's on. The fans are really quiet on high level games. Everything's high right now, as you can see.
They went this way.
Try to pick up. Got it. I don't have a gun. I gotta go get a gun real quick.